this hockey game ends with no scoring, so it's sudden death overtime. Tremendous burst of speed in overtime. Kenny Mazdell of Montreal, number 18, over the Detroit blue line, around the backhand. It's in! Mazdell has scored! The game is over! The Canadians win in overtime and still alive in this sensational Cup Finals. The Red Wings still lead, though, 3-2.
The unforgettable 1953-1954 Stanley Cup between the Detroit Red Wings and the Montreal Canadiens is the theme of our show this week on The Way It Was. I'm Kurt Gowdy. Welcome to our series of American Sports Classics. Today, one of the greatest series in the National Hockey League's battle for the Stanley Cup. And here to help us relive that incredible championship series, the challenging Detroit Red Wings. The 1954 Norris Trophy winner, four-time Lady Byng winner, high-scoring defenseman, the Hall of Famer, number 4, Red Kelly. The captain, the left winger, Art Ross Trophy winner, veteran of 17 National Hockey League seasons, Hall of Famer number 7, Ted Lindsay. One of the smallest players of the National Hockey League. One of the best checking forwards in the game, number 8, the Mighty Mouse, Tony Leswick. And for the defending Stanley Cup champs, the Montreal Canadiens, probably the greatest goalie in National Hockey League history. A rookie that year of 53-54. He went on to win the Vezina Trophy a record 7 times. Number 1, Jacques Plante. Winner of the Calder Trophy, the Hart Trophy, and the Art Ross Trophy twice. Master of the slap shot, one of the greatest scorers in National Hockey League history, number 5, Bernie Boom Boom Jeffrion. And the first string all-star National Hockey League forward, and that year, top 10 scoring, number 18, Ken Mosdell. And we're very happy to have one of the top play-by-play hockey announcers, the man who described that series, the voice of the Detroit Red Wings, Bud Lynch. Bud, welcome. And at this stage, as we watch great hockey, just 6 professional hockey teams, they had so many hundreds and thousands of young players who couldn't make it at that time. These men were so great with only 6 teams.
You're right, Kurt. The 1953-54 era, in that particular period of time, 2 Canadian teams, 4 American teams. Every player that had a chance to play pro hockey had pride in wearing that jersey. 120 made it to the National Hockey League. And you're looking at some of them right now, and it's one of those situations in that day, players wanted to play hockey, and to make it, they had to put out 60 minutes every game. But that was a thrilling year, though.
Well, it was, and let's set up that year now. Tell us about the semifinals that year that set up the finals for the Stanley Cup.
Well, Kurt, Detroit won the league championship, and of course, that meant extra money to the boys. That helped. And then for the Stanley Cup playoffs, they beat Toronto in 5 games, and Lindsay and Kelly did very well there. And the Montreal Canadiens, who had finished 2nd in season play but had won the Cup the year before, they took care of the Boston Bruins in the semifinals, and they had great goalkeeping from a young kid, a rookie at that time, the name of Jacques Plante. And then they beat Boston 4 straight to face the Red Wings in the Stanley Cup of 53-54.
Well, that set it up. So let's go back now to April 4th, 1954, to the Olympia in Detroit. Play-by-play action, and here's Bud Lynch.
Great inter-city, international rivalry between Detroit and Montreal, 2 powerhouses of pro hockey in the 1954 Stanley Cup. The referee, number 1, Bill Chadwick.
And now the lineups for the Montreal Canadiens in goal, Jacques Plante. On the defense, Doug Harvey and Tom Johnson. The starting forward line of Bernie Jeffrion, Floyd Curry, and Kenny Mosdell. For the Detroit Red Wings in goal, Terry Sawchuk. On the defense, Bob Golub and Red Kelly. And a starting forward trio of Ted Lindsay, Alex Delvecchio, and Gordie Howe.
Game number 1 underway. Mitro Presta against Paul Masnik in the first period. The Wings from their own end zone. Number 9 of the Canadiens, Rocket Richard. Number 3, Detroit's Marcel Pronovol gets hooked here by Dickie Moore. Moore gets a 2-minute penalty, and the Wings' power play opportunity starts. Number 14 is Dutch Rival. He gets a shot from the blue line. And it actually hits Ted Lindsay's stick and scores. The Wings go ahead 1-0, 13:44 in the first period. Still in the first period, Reibel gets a pass to the strong right winger Gord Howe. But the shot is stopped by netminder Jacques Klein. In the second period, number four, Jean Beliveau of Montreal, gets a pass to Dickie Moore, but he's taken out of the play by Glenn Scove, number 12. Scove gets a two-minute minor penalty, and the Canadiens have their power play opportunity. Number two, Doug Harvey of the Montreal Canadiens, sets up number five, Bernie Jeffrioni, shoots and scores. A power play goal, the game tied 1-1, 12-16, second period. The Wings Kronobo pass to Ted Lindsay. His shot is blocked. The rebound to Dutch Reibel, and Dutch Reibel gets a break here and scores. The Wings go ahead 2-1. 1:52 in the third period. Minutes later, Pavlich again for Detroit. Sets up number four, Red Kelly. And Kelly in front shoots and scores. 7:13 in the third period. The Red Wings win. Game number one at home, 3-1. Steered the puck in with his glove. The game ends 1-1. Sudden death overtime coming up. Tension really builds. No score, no chance for error. The Canadians working in the Detroit zone. Sawchuk tips it back. Rocket recharge, steals it back in the net, steers it around the boards. The Wings trying to come out of their own zone. Mikko Prestai to center ice. A dump pass. Skov in along the boards, fires it around the board. Harvey, number two from Montreal, clears it. Leswick is at the blue line. He waits, he shoots. It's in the net. The game is over. We're off. Doug Harvey's glove. Leswick, 5'6", is mobbed by his teammates. An unlikely hero. Number eight breaks this hockey game. Wraps up the season. The Mighty Mouse, number eight, Tony Leswick, a real hero at the Olympia Stadium. The coach, Tommy Ivan. And league president Clarence Campbell presents the coveted Stanley Cup to the captain, Ted Lindsay. He and Marcel Korda will plant victory kisses. The 1954 Stanley Cup champions, the Detroit Red Wings.
Tony, you're the hero. The shot wins the Stanley Cup. It deflected off Doug Harvey's glove. Tell us the way it was.
Well, it was a change. I just got on the ice, and I just happened to be in the right spot at the right time. And when you say I was a hero, I don't know. I was traded next year to Chicago.
Well, you're a hero that night. But
there are a lot of things happened after
that series.
Tommy Ivan, the coach, went to Chicago Blackhawks. Some of the players didn't come back. There are a lot of things happened. But the Mighty Mouse was duly congratulated that night, I'm sure. I think his 5'6" frame went down to 5'2" before the players got through with him.
And Tony, I'm going to give him credit for one thing. He was 5'6", but full of desire and full of guts. And that's what I admired Tony Leswick.
That's about the nice life. Thing you said about me in all these years.
Well, I have no choice. You grab on the door for me.
Honest to God.
Emotionalism always enters into sports, sentimentality. And after that seventh game, it was a Stanley Cup tradition for the Stanley Cup handshake. And the Canadiens did not go through with it. Now, what's the story on that?
Well, we all went there and shook hands with the Detroit Red Wing.
Not that night, even. Not that night.
Now, let's find out about this. This is a tradition. They say you fell skated off the ice and didn't shake hands with the champ.
Guys didn't go out with that. Means he was not in the lineup.
No, he was in.
He went in the room right away. We shook hands with a few of the guys.
Kissing that cup.
Yeah.
I didn't go in.
Were you ordering? The only thing that we didn't like is they had champagne, we had Coke.
Yeah, not bad.
No, but were you ordered not to shake hands with him?
Never.
No way.
That's not a tradition of a National Hockey League. Win or lose, you shake hands and that's it. I mean, they won the game. They were a better team that year, and that's it.
You can't be happy because somebody's beat you. I realize you have to respect the man for his talents of that night or in that series for beating you, and you should swallow your pride and maybe shake hands with him. But sometimes maybe the emotions just get a little bit too strong, and right on the spur of the moment you're mad. Maybe it was the last play of the game or something, and you might have made a mental error that cost something, and you just don't want to shake hands with anybody. You want to get away.
Certainly. I introduced the members there to start our show. Hall of Famers, all-stars, all-time greats, and that's just what that series was all about, one of the most dramatic series of all time. I want to thank the members of the Stanley Cup champs, the Detroit Red Wings, the Montreal Canadiens, and Bud Lynch, who was there on the scene calling that series. And so ended the most intense, bitterly fought battle for the Stanley Cup in National Hockey League history. For the Canadiens, their disappointment should be well tempered with pride. A trophy that men have spent fortunes and lifetimes pursuing. A trophy, when donated by Lord Stanley in 1893, cost a grand total of $48.67. And this is Kurt Gowdy saying that's the way it was when the Detroit Red Wings beat the Montreal Canadiens in the 1953-54 Stanley Cup Championship Series.